UA. Say it with me. Beat UA. Well, it's back. We're back, finally. It's time for a bit of sob. You know, sob, a good race. Oh, geez. So UA is back, and we're looking for a nice, calm start. Nicely done, a very easy, clean sweep. I mean, come on, just attack demons! Why me? Oh, we're absolutely done for. These guys are pretty good, but I never built a boss, and I'm getting... Right, okay, well, we know we're dead, so let's just make this life easier and see how bad this actually was. Right, so here's my plan for attempt two. We're going to not rush, okay? I'm telling you right now, we're not rushing, okay? Playing against AI rushing does not work, okay? I feel that now. So what I'm going to do instead is take the furthest points I can and fortify both locations. Hot. Chaos Demons again? Are you serious right now? Look, we'll be ready for their annoying army, right? Here we go. Same old story. Letting demons tech is so fun. Oh, I just give over with this. Right, third time lucky. Now, the way I did it last time did kind of work, but I feel like I didn't build a big enough army. So that's what I'm going to do this time. I'm going to go for a bigger army. A tier 2 massive army. Newsflash, I didn't even get tier 2 this game. I decided to rush instead, and things didn't go well. Yep, Inquisition got tier 2, and of course, me, knowing me, I'm not going to stand around for that, and rage quit. So yeah, I'm having a lot of fun right now, not going to lie. Coming back to UA after all this time, this is why I take breaks, guys. It's a stressful series. Well, fourth time's the charm now, I guess. I'm going to go back to my roots. The tech one worked the best, in my opinion, so I'm going to do that one again. You know, where we get the gens up straight away and then points down. That's what I'm going to do this time. So, you know, I'm mopped out with points, and then I just go for the second tier for Celestians and I win that way. Now we spam Seraphons! That was my plan. Get a nice load of resources, then spam Seraphons. Alright guys, so here we are, once again on attempt 4. I decided to not bother recording any of it, because it was basically a tech up. Nothing's really much has happened. I've had a very lucky start here. So, hopefully now, we're going to actually get somewhere in this series. My plan is to just sort my resource out problem out. Now luckily, all three are fighting each other, which is very useful for me. Okay, so we're looking pretty good, looking strong. So I'm not rushing into this. I don't think it's a good idea to rush into it. We're probably better off getting to full tier, to be honest. I do feel like that's better. We're going to be killing orcs anyway, with just the bus alone. You can see we're slowly taking down their army. I just don't want to get involved with any fights right now, because let's be real, my wreck's not the best right now. We're fighting the orcs, so it makes total sense for us. What am I doing? Why is he still there? Bring him back. Right, we need our army ready for the demons. Now, demons are OP. It's official. They are absolutely ridiculous. But we need to sort our faith out, we need to get everything sorted so we can get our Archangel. I feel like our Archangel is probably the only way to defeat demons. The faster two occasions we face demons, it's gone badly. So we're going to go next tier. We should get some more of these to stop any individual units. But yeah, orcs shouldn't be a threat, we should be okay against orcs. They haven't really managed to tech up. I think we should set up a base of operations so we can constantly spam units if possible. So get a couple of barracks down like this. I don't know how long we've got until the demons decide to go mental and attack me, but we got a bit of time. We should get a bunch of lightning strikes out, I think. That's another thing, we need to make a vehicle facility as well. Then a small Celestian army to kill orcs. I think we kill them pretty easy. They're just a nuisance being there. Right, so they've been killed. Okay, they're coming for me. Ooh, that's a big army. Move our artillery back. Bring these guys over. This is a bit ridiculous, to be honest. Oh.
I've come to talk with you again.
Oh. Well, okay. So I'm back. I'm back again. Right, it's attempt 6. I'm about ready to absolutely throw my PC out the window, but I looked at a little strategies online. I've not done that for a while. And apparently sub flamers are OP in the early game. So here is my plan. I'm going to span flamers. Sub flamers. We're going to spam some sub flamers. Apparently they're super OP. My brain's just fried. I feel like I'm getting worse the more I play this, so I think we should better stop. Okay, here we go. Attempt number 6. Ready to go. I think I've figured out how to do this. It's playing a very patient game, though. A very patient game. The AI do it. They actually set up fortifications so that they're safe from attack. And they just keep rebuilding. Always. That's how you do it. So, the plan is to go barracks. 3 of these. And 2 gen. You capture your inner points first, because your inner points are kind of more important than your outer points to start off with. You need to get the wreck flowing. Get that requisition flowing very quickly. Though, I really should underestimate turrets. They are good. We should build them. My plan is to literally defend these two fronts until I have the full sub army ready to attack with a deadly blow of Celestians, complete with vehicles. Right, so here they come. So I was too concentrated to actually talk here, so I'm voiceovering here. And as you can see, the big battle is about to start. This is the first action really of this battle, because everyone was teching up. It was a very techy sort of affair from everyone. Everyone just was teching. And as you can see, I've got my tanks out, my Celestians. I'm bringing more tanks over to support. This is a very crucial battle here. We cannot lose this. If we lose this, well, it's another rage quit, or I get mad, or, you know. Like I said, I took a day break. Well, not a day break. I literally went off because I was getting so tilted. And I come back on the next day, hoping to win it. First try. Are we going to do that, though? Well, you're about to find out, obviously. We are pushing Eldar back now, as you can see, using my little tricky flamer tactics with my eliminators. These attempts are good than you think. They are nicely usable, but obviously you don't want to spam them. And you don't want to fall behind too much, because if you fall behind too much, you have a bit of a problem, yeah. As you can see, look at my face. So focused right now, making sure I win this battle. I honestly, at this point, I'm super, super tired of losing. After a while, this is why I take long breaks with UA, because it just becomes not fun anymore. When you're constantly getting dicked on, after a while, you just want to stop. It's human nature. We don't like being battered. So, of course, we stop or do something different, play another game. I'm playing League of Legends after this. Maybe not the best game to play, but just play anything other than UA. Is what I was thinking last night before I went off. After that, just incredible fail with the flamers. But this is doing a lot better. We are pushing back the Eldar nice and swiftly with our stops. Never mind. They're now being bullshit. And they're sending all sorts. And they're probably going to take this point now. Actually, no, I've still got my army. Let's go back in. We can still win this. Oh, got my point. Ah, lovely. It's fine, right? We know how annoying Eldar are. Let's just kill them. Yeah? Let's just kill them instead. Let's just go in and murder their faces instead. How's that sound? Sounds lovely. Yeah, I like that idea. Let's burn them alive. Come on. Do it. Die, Falcon. You will die, Falcon. I mean it. Ball. Jesus, why are they so tanky? But honestly, when I was playing this, I was wondering why they were so tanky. Eldar vehicles are crap before they get their shield. For some strange reason, I lose my army here. And I can see where this is going now. Lost my army. I can look at the body language on my face right now. And I can tell you right now that, yeah, that was always going to happen. Losing it again. All agree on that? Right. Okay, attempt 6, here we go. I've got a very good way of winning this one. Yeah. Kron! The joys! They made their early game stronger! Why would they do that? Tom was just so weak. I know it's Kron now, so... I'm gonna fuck him. Hang on, the builder sob rush. What about this? There's a builder to kill buildings, can't you? We stop the summoning code with the builder. I'm getting desperate. Stop the summoning core. That's all you gotta do. Follow them. Follow them. Build a bunch of builders. This is what you call desperate now. Rushing with sob builders. This is what you call a dick move. Oh. Kron couldn't get going. I stopped the summoning core. This is how desperate I am now. This is the 7th attempt. I'm that desperate to win this now. I would do a dick move like this, but that is a rush for the future. Do not lose heart. I don't think it'd work on anyone else other than Kron. You could try it, maybe on... No, because they would already have like cutlass out and stuff if it was Chaos or Scouts. Should definitely build a second HQ and just basically monopolize the map now. Just keep builders there repairing that. Okay. Now if we're getting the Confessor and the Advanced Builder out as well. And look, all we gotta do now is hope that this battle goes on for a long time. In fact, this is so worth a save. There's a big battle going on in the middle right now. So there's nowhere that these guys die yet. Either of them. I submit. We are taking fire! I essentially have monopolization of the map, so I can chill out now. Which is exactly what I do. I just chill out, get my armies up to a very high standards, and then attack with everything. And guys, we will see how this goes for us, because finally we're going to get to see a good side of Sob. It has been a horrible 2 days, and hopefully now, it's currently 3 o'clock in the afternoon, can I finally beat UA? Let's find out. How do we get more Relic resources? Of course, I'm an absolute moron. I actually feel like a moron. How else would you get relic resources as well? Oh, of course, you build the relic. I don't. We're breeding an army for one purpose, to finally beat this map. Beat this map with this race. I'm making sure I don't miss anything here. And let's hope this works out. I am such an idiot though. I could have had the Archangel ages ago. Oh, tell you what. I do make some daft choices sometimes. What the fuck? I've been concentrating so much this game that I hardly ever commentated. So I'm having to voice over more often than usual. But yeah, my army has just been primed and ready for ages. I now have the Faith all researched. I am currently working on the Archangel. Chaos are now starting to attack. As you can see, they're using their artillery and their goddamn annoying shrines. We all love shrines, don't we, against the Chaos. They seem to be annoyingly powerful. I noticed they also have a deserted castle as well, so they're going to be firing warp storms on me soon. We probably need to make a move now, to be honest. It would be probably the best option. Chaos are currently attacking Dark Eldar, so we just need to make a move soon, really. I can't express enough how much we need to make a move right now. So I think it was time that we did do that. Well, this lord did okay to tank things, but it's still getting absolutely slaughtered by those shrines. There's so many shrines. Like Jesus, how many shrines do you want? Oh, and now they're attacking with berserkers, who are absolutely OP, by the way. They take so long to go down, it's ridiculous. But we should be fine. This is a very high-skilled sob army I have now. With the proper Celestians, artillery, and angels. And I'm still working on that Archangel. But I am going to nuke their deserted castle, because it needs to die now. The bus is ready. Right. You've let me tech up. Finally. I win this now. I'm that confident I win this now. So, it's almost ready, the Archangel now. We've just got to hold a little bit longer. That's all now. Just a little bit longer, and we will have our Archangel. It's been very stalemate, really. We've just been using our artillery to take down their shrines, which has kind of been failing. Our bus is sort of just doing nothing for some reason. The nerf bus is pretty hard, it looks like. They used to be able to absolutely destroy buildings. They seem to be more of a transport ship now, more than anything. And they have a Titan, so that's fun. We really could do with our Archangel now, to be honest. Really could do with it. Like, when the hell is it ready? It's got to be soon. Oh, he's ready. Right, let's do this. Let's make short work of this guy. You just activated my trap card. It is now time to destroy chaos. We're ready to go in. It's time to annihilate. Our Archangel is at ready, and he's going to go and do some damage. All right, let's do this. Let's speed up some time, and let's watch as this angel absolutely destroys chaos. Cue the music. Them again so we can get more health. 18,000 health now. Look at them. What do you think this is?
An emissary to your majesty.
Do you really think you can survive? That castle will be up soon. When it is, your days are at an end. I think you basically can build it straight away. Castle is almost ready. I don't have to wait for the castle. I could technically win pretty easily now. But this is cool. There we go. Let's use it over here. Right on Dark Eldar. Do the trick. Show me. Watch the destruction.
No one is above.
I embody the Emperor's
Let's move back a little bit, because this does a lot of damage. I'm not kidding. I embody the Emperor's wrath. There you go.
The Inquisition is not so easily rebuked.
Oh, wow. That's brightness. How are Chaos not dead off that? Oh, what the hell was it? Must have been a vehicle pit or something. I'm not too sure. But yes! Yes! I knew I could do it today! And I did it. On the sixth attempt, it's been very painful. But we have achieved... Some are good. You just have to get the shrine. Then they become good. Before their shrine, though, they do seem a bit weak. They don't really have anything going for them. Their units die a bit too easily. Once you get faith going, though, and rolling up and getting those angels out, it changes quite a bit for them. They are top beaten. We've done it, right? That is done. We can move on to the next race, finally. I honestly was going mad because I started this project at 4 yesterday. It is now 12 today, so that's a lot of hours. Now, obviously, I had to go to bed and stuff, but yeah, that's a lot of hours. Say 4 till midnight, and then 8:30 till now. So, yes, it took a long time. Our match. We did it. They're done. We don't have to play sob now until the next map. Thank God. Right? Just, no, thank God. Oh, there were so many more races to go. Why do I do this series? Why do I put myself through this pain? I don't need to put myself through this pain when I decide to do it. Am I heck doing the next race? I'm Dawn Award out. That's a word, Dawn Award out. Dawn Award, I don't know. Me. Thanks so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please leave a like, make sure to subscribe. Comment your thoughts on this episode, of course. And I will see you in the next episode. If you guys are enjoying the green screen in the corner, I am probably going to do this for Minecraft as well. With the green screen, man. Hello, I'm over here in the corner. But yeah, anyway. Bye.